Asian High Society is out in force tonight to celebrate the first anniversary of the film gossip magazine Cineblitz. If you're wondering why that should create such glittering interest, I'll let you in on a secret. Among the many stars on show here tonight, and there are many, is the one and only Amitabh Bachchan, hero of 100 Hindi movies. So let's go in and get a taste of the action. The party doubled as a tribute to Amitabh, who arrived with his wife Jaya, herself a star of the 70s, and his mother, Theji. Amitabh Bachchan has been India's biggest star for 15 years. He leapt to the top playing the angry young man, fighting injustice and, of course, winning against all the odds.
Anthony Gonzalez.
His endless series of victories for the underdog gave him mass appeal in India. Amitabh's popularity spread to the Middle East, the Soviet Union, and inevitably throughout Asian communities everywhere, Britain being no exception.
I'm proud that the people of this country, they are giving him so much love and affection. Because I feel, my dear girl, an actor is an actor as long as he has his audiences giving him love and affection. However great an actor he may be.
I think it's very reassuring for an artist to get this kind of response, and especially away, you know, out of your own country.
Amitabh is certainly a subject of adulation over here, but back home his film idol crown has slipped. His latest movies have flopped, and he's been docked by controversy after a sudden and short-lived entry into Indian politics following the assassination of Mrs. Gandhi in 1984.
I didn't know anything about politics. I still don't. And my idea of politics was perhaps fighting an election, looking after a constituency, and that's it. Subsequently, of course, I came to know that that's not what politics is all about. It's about power lobbies, and it's about manipulations and forming groups and using pressure tactics, which is something that I just didn't know anything about.
That's my printer.
Despite his ignorance of politics, Amitabh was able to get elected as an MP for Allahabad. His political foray also resulted in accusations of his involvement in the Bofors scandal, which revolved around an arms deal with the Swedish firm Bofors.
You have got caught up in all the various dirty tricks of politics. Your name has been linked with the Bofors scandal. Can you tell me what, if any, part you played in the Bofors scandal?
Nothing.
Why then have accusations been made about you?
Well, the reason why I resigned was that various allegations were thrown at me. I felt it morally right to resign and wait for them to prove anything. Nothing has appeared at all in any form. There's been no form of any evidence, and I'm prepared to get hanged or get punished for whatever is there. But so long as they do not have hard facts, kindly do not indulge in any further innuendos, because for 4.5 years, that's all you've done, and you haven't proved anything.
Do you think the fact that you went off into politics has put people off you now that you have returned to acting?
I would like to believe that the people who go to see my firm go to see the firm because I'm an actor and not a politician. However, I am unable to defend this argument when I look at it with the kind of businesses that my firm have been doing recently.
I was just
they aren't doing well.
Back at the party, the latest Indian fashions were given extra sparkle by an Amitabh backdrop. And in the audience was the film Dream Girl, Hema Malini.
I worked with him, about 6 to 7 films with him, and they were all big hits.
Hindi films have never boasted much variety in plot or character, but Amitabh Bachchan is finding that popular taste is moving away from his kind of action movie towards tales of romance. He has come to accept that he's past his peak of popularity.
There comes a time when people get fed up of seeing the same face over and over again. And I think that time has come now that people want to see fresher leading ladies, and it's time that we backed up and did something else.
Amitabh may be uncertain about his future career in Bombay's film industry, but one thing he can be sure of is the support of his British fans. His recent visit to Leicester drew over 6,000 people who queued for hours to catch a glimpse of their idol. The local MP, Keith Vaz, was understandably envious of his pulling power.
I don't think I can ever recall a circumstance in Leicester where there were so many people outside. All I can say to you, as a former Member of Parliament, is please don't stand in Leicester East.
Thank you.
So what is the man's magic for the fans who waited over 3 hours and survived the crush just for a quick look?
He's a handsome actor, and he's so brilliant. I like meeting him. I shook hands with him, and I enjoyed it.
Everything is special about Amitabh. He's just an excellent actor. He's brilliant. He's handsome. What more do you want?
I had to wait there about 3 hours, 3.5 hours, just to get his autograph. But it was really great because I think a lot of him.
I like his character. I've read magazines about him. And he's known to be very kind. And I just like everything about him.
And he sort of felt my cheek like that. So I said, can I give you a kiss? And he said, yeah. So I just kissed him and he kissed me.
He is the ideal man for me.
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah. Anytime.